Good to you. You are welcome to today's Open Heaven Review. And today is 2nd of April, year 2021. So today we want to consider the topic, the Spirit, the Word, and the Blood. The Spirit, the Word, and the Blood. Shall we pray? Father, we bless you for another day. And we thank you for bringing us into the light of the understanding of your Word. We say, be exalted in the name of Jesus. Father, as we have come to hear from you, please open up your mind to us and let your word be impactful. Make us a better person and let all this you have made available for us be our portion. Thank you, dear Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. One more time, you are welcome. We want to consider the Spirit, the Word, and the Blood. In the meantime, our memory verse is from the book of 1 John, chapter 5, verse 7. 1 John, chapter 5, verse 7. For there are three that bear records in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. There are three that bear records in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. And these three are one. They are one. So, our Bible passage is from book of Hebrews chapter 12, 22-25. Hebrews chapter 12, 22-25. The Bible says, but ye are come unto Mount Zion, and unto the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, and to an innumerable company of angels, to the general assembly and the church of the firstborn, which are written in heaven, and to God the judge of all, and to the spirit of just men made perfect, and to Jesus the mediator of the new covenant, and to the word, and to the blood of sprinkling that speaketh better things than that of Abel. See that ye refuse not him that speaketh, for if they escape now who refuse him that speak on earth, much more shall not we escape if we turn away from him that speaketh from heaven. May the Lord bless his word in the name of Jesus. Our memory verse is talking about the witnesses that we have in heaven. The witnesses that we have in heaven, the Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. The Father, the Word, and the Holy Ghost. Now, on earth currently, the Word is here. We have the Word of God. Jesus has been here. Holy Spirit is with us, you see. So, these are the witnesses that we have all around us. The Father also is much more present here. So, you know what happened? What is God expecting from us? Being his own children. He has given us the Spirit. He has given us the Word. He has given us the blood. Now these are the weapons that the Father has given for his own children to fight in the battle of life. Now if you look at that verse 22 of Hebrews that we read, Hebrews chapter 12. So we have come unto Mount Zion, unto the city of the living God, the heavenly Jerusalem, unto an innumerable company of angels, to the general assembly and the church of the firstborn which are written in heaven, and to God the judge of all, bear records. So the one who will judge must have record. So he bear records. And to the spirit of just men made perfect. You hear the Father there, so you hear the Spirit there. Now look at verse 24. And to Jesus, the mediator of the new covenant. So you see the Father, you see the Spirit, and you see the Son, which is Jesus, is the mediator of the new covenant. And to the blood, of sprinkling that speaketh better things than that of Abel, So you have Jesus who is the Word, you have the Father who is God, then you have the blood of Jesus, then you have the Spirit who is the Holy Ghost. Now, right from the beginning, the Father has been, the Word has been, the Spirit has been. But you know what happened? A time came that the sin came in, and when sin came, the blood is required. So blood came in to take away the sin of men, So the Spirit, the Word of God, and the blood of Jesus are the three irresistible and the potent weapon of the spiritual warfare provided by God the Father for his own children. So he has given us this for us to fight with, and we must make use of them. John 6:63, it is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. The word that I speak to you, their spirit and their life. Words are so powerful. Word of God are so powerful. When they go forth, they bring about spirit, they bring about life. You cannot separate them. They bring about spirit, they bring about life. John chapter 1 verse 3, John 1 chapter verse 1 verse 3, John chapter 1 verse 3 says, all things were made by him, that is by the word. So the word can be creative. The word you speak can be creative. If you speak it in God, it can be creative. And without him, nothing was made. So the word was in the beginning. It brought about the creation, and God established that without the word, nothing was made. So if you too make use of the power that is in the word, you can create a better situation for yourself. You can create a better home for yourself. You can create a better marriage for yourself. You can create a better future for yourself, because when you speak, things happen. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 to 3. Genesis chapter 1 verse 1 to 3. So you will see that the spirit and the word, they complement each other. They complement each other. You cannot separate them. You cannot separate them. So, and they bring order into everything you want them to be, because when you speak, it becomes a spirit and it becomes life. So when the sin came to the world and everything was altered, it is the blood that came in to put things in shape. So you make use of the word. The spirit follows, and you make use of the blood. Let me say this way. The spirit helps you to speak the right word. And when the right word goes forth, it becomes spirit, it becomes life. And you know what happened? Then the blood of Jesus is make use of to bring things back into shape, to bring things back into shape. So you must make use of all these things. So when a child of God is filled with the Holy Spirit, as well as armed with the word of God and the blood of Jesus, we can say that the victory is fully decided in its our favor. So when you have all these things on your side, then the victory is already been made available for you. When the blood is speaking good for you, when the word is on your side, when the spirit is on your side, everything is in shape for you. So you know what the Bible said, where we read in our text, it said the blood speak a better thing than that of Abel. What does it speak? The blood speaks justification in place of condemnation. The blood speaks life in place of death. The blood speaks, resurrection in place of you remaining in grave. You know what the blood speaks? The blood speaks something good, a better marriage, a better future, a better peace, a better tomorrow. That's what the blood is speaking. The blood continues to speak, all because the blood is in your favor. When things are in your favor, when those things are standing on your part, it brings about the victory that God has made available for you. The blood still speaks. The word still carries life. The spirit is still on your side. The spirit beareth witness with our whole spirit that we are the sons of God, that we are the sons of God. So when the so-called child of God disregards God's word, such is going to fall into sin. And the victory will not be decided in the favor of such. It will not. God's word says you abstain from sin. That's God's word. You make use of the word. God's word says you should believe in God. So you believe in God. You know, God's word says you should walk in righteousness. You do that. You don't despise God's word. So when you place value on the word, you place value on the blood, and you place value on the spirit, the victory is decided for you in your favor. So having established today that we have this weapon that is made available for us, can you please begin to make use of it? Let the blood speak for you. Let the spirit help you to pray. Let the word of God be in your mouth so that you don't sin. Let it be in your heart so that you don't sin against the Father. So begin to make use of all these things. And for those things to work for you, you must have been redeemed by the blood. So are you redeemed by the blood? If not, tell the Father that God, forgive me my sin. Redeem me by your blood. Wash me in your blood. And you begin to make use of the word of God. Begin to make use of the spirit of the Father. Begin to make use of those things, because they are here. You are to make use of them. And when they are in your favor one more time, victory is decided for you. What is the action point for today? You are to begin to put the word of God into proper application in your daily life. Plead the blood of Jesus on all negative situations in your life. And do not grieve the Holy Spirit. Father, we thank you for your word. We ask for the grace to use rightly your word. We ask for the grace for us to make use of the blood. And we ask for the grace not to grieve the Holy Spirit. Please give unto us. Bless all these our listeners. And let them be glorified. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. You are blessed, brethren. Do have a wonderful time.